So I would ask, how do you practice?
Well, I was born into Sufism. That is a long life journey. But my father was not a dictator. So he did not say, well, because you are my daughter, you have to become a Sufi. No. Actually, I looked at him and I really wanted to have what he has or what he had. I had seen him so reverent to many people. Amongst his followers were people of other religions. And I actually remember that one of the people who was of another monotheistic tradition asked him and said, well, I want to convert to Islam. And he said, I don't understand. What are you talking about? We are not this kind of system that we would like to convert to another kind of system. If we truthfully understand the basic of the teachings of these teachers, you know, at the level of meaning, we all are practicing the same thing. So he was very reverent or honorable to many people, including myself. So actually, I liked to learn what he knew, and I want to understand what he did. So that was the beginning of my search for Sufism. And over time, of course, I have learned how to practice and how to meditate, how ultimately come to that confidence that makes me at peace with myself and also makes me at peace with everybody else's faith system and tradition.
Thank you. What would you say as a Sufi? What about your practice, the teachings of Sufism, is most inspiring to you and most challenging?
Well, this is true of all spiritual paths. And I use the spiritual because sometimes when we talk about religion, it immediately becomes this religion or that religion. When we talk about the spiritual, it means that it is a more expanded vision. It is inclusive. One of the beauty of Sufism, and I'm sure it is true of all other spiritual practices, but in this case, I'm only talking about Sufism, is that with that word of poetry and that word, those wordings and talks that really relates to human emotion and human heart and the deep side of human, that is the most fascinating part of Sufism. There are subjects that when we would like to talk, become into debate and disagreement with one another. But if the same thing is said in the language of poetry, we see a whole different story to that, because it works with the human emotion, and suddenly the intellectual reasoning that just traps us into this side or that side, it just falls apart and becomes a matter of heart. The challenging part is that sometimes we think simply because I'm a spiritual, I am done. And that is the beginning of things. You actually have to become. It does not happen overnight. And sometimes the practices are difficult, challenging. How many times you fall, it is just another story. One of the things that Rumi said about Shams was that, you believe me that thousands of times I lost my hope in Shams, then I, you know, again raise up and I begin to become. All the challenges of human being is there with the word of a spiritual. That doesn't change. One thing that I have realized is that there are people who are fit for a spiritual path, and there are people who just love a spiritual path, and there are people who really don't care. The people who are fit a spiritual path is just like the people who have been born with the musical talent, with the poetic talent, with the scientific talent. Those people, no matter what you do with them, they always find their way. And then there are people who love those, you know, practices. They are the ones who most likely would have the challenge, meaning that they ultimately have to push themselves in one side or the other. And the third group of people who really don't care about the rest of us, that's okay too. And that is clear cut. They don't have to face any challenge. They are okay with what, wherever they are. The second group are the people who have challenges. I give you an example. No matter what time era, what culture, what system, what religion Jesus was born into, he would always be Jesus. That would not change, because this man has that qualities in himself that he cannot do anything other than being Jesus. So this person doesn't have any challenge. He accepts everything because he that is a part of him. The challenge is with the people who love him and they want to practice what he practices. Those are the people who are facing challenge. And the people who don't care about that, those teachings, they are fine. They are at peace with themselves.
Mm.